definitely soccer. Soccer's my passion, actually. When I see a soccer ball, I just run after it. I feel like a 5-year-old kid. Yeah. I was like some inattentive kid filming, you know, because I would run after the ball and then the director would have to get me back, haul me back and say like, look, stop. Yeah, it was quite funny. And actually, when I took up the show, when I heard there was a soccer show, I went to the producer. I said, I must be in the show. I said, I'm the best soccer player in Mediacorp. No, I was just joking. I mean, like, it's seldom that I'm so confident about something. But because I love playing soccer, I don't mean I'm not the best. I'm just saying, like, Ian, Ke Ping Tao Ke, they all play very well. I'm just saying I want to be involved in the show. And I'm glad that I was involved and had so much fun. Yeah, but I also realized that filming a soccer show is not entirely like playing soccer. The difference is that some of the actors can't play soccer. The difference is that in one take, you might have to have A passing to B to C and then into goal at this angle, at this corner. Even professional footballers might not be able to do it in a few takes, you know. So there were so many times we took like 20 takes just to have the correct movement and stuff. Because, yeah. So, yeah, it was quite hard. And also, it was really scorching hot then. So, yeah, but we had fun. We were like a bunch of kids, like actually. The guys, when we were together, they told you about how we would be hanky-panky with each other when we... that's because... No, okay, on the field, we'd be very serious and like, wow, we're fighting spirit and stuff. But maybe in a changing room, you know, guys, we'll always be guys. And then up to stupid pranks. And then when there are no ladies around, then they do stupid things. So then I don't know who started. We started attacking each other like... At funny areas lah. Then we ended up doing that. So it was quite funny lah that we would do that. I don't understand how we came to do that. I think football is a really sexy sport. Let's talk about, like, the World Cup is coming. This show is in conjunction with the World Cup. Soccer, I think generally a lot of sports would be sexy because when you have so much concentration, you're focused on what you're doing, so serious. I think that there's some beauty in it. And let's say soccer, previous World Cups, maybe more last time than now, you always have big characters like heroes, like Romario to Roberto Baggio to Valderrama with his big hairdo. Then you have like pink jerseys, you have tight jerseys, and then the passion that goes on. So I think it's a really sexy sport that gets you involved. Previously, I also did sailing and wrestling for different roles previously. So I think wrestling is something that I hate doing. I had to do a lot of wrestling in a show called Together previously. So I don't understand why there's so much physical contact and then why you have to punch and kick and get all violent. And I didn't understand that. It was quite tough for me lah. So wrestling is something violent like that is not something I would want to take up. Not violent, of course, I don't understand the sport. Wrestlers or people who are into MMA would say, wow, it's so man, they like it so much, but it's not for me. I think I'm a very competitive person. More so when you can see that on the soccer pitch. I hate losing. I make sure I'll scold my teammates. I'll squat down if they make a mistake. Or of course, yeah. Or I would scold them. Or if I play badly, I'll feel very down. I think you have to be serious about what you're doing. And even in sport, if you want to just, I think so friendly, competitive. I think that's the spirit. Yeah. Because just now, let's say. I find it strange, you know, like playing soccer, then it's like you're looking all suave and like handsome and or maybe like idol. I find it strange that this idol thing, this idol baggage or this thing about being handsome or not. I don't think that myself, but this thing seems to be used against me. When it is something, it's a strong point, it's something that is supposed to be good, but it seems that it's used, for example, the host was asking me, when are you going to do a not handsome role? I'm like, my mom gave me this face, I don't think I'm handsome, but the thing is, why is that used against me as a baggage or as a weapon to attack me? I find that really strange, especially when, for an actor, it comes to a stage where I'm in transition slowly. So. I just want to voice this and it gets me a bit frustrated. But I find it really strange that it should be used as a weapon against me. Because I'm just working hard on my trade and I'm just maturing like any other guy and then slowly maturing and getting into my roles and doing them seriously. I don't see myself as an idol. I actually don't have that baggage. I actually don't think like I'm handsome. Most of the time when I look in the mirror, I'm like, I look quite bad today. So it's something that people put on me, and I don't think it's fair that I just want to get out of it. But I'm not so eager to get out of it. I'm like, okay, if I'm casted in this role, then I am. If I have to be ugly, then I am. If I was some uncle, boarding uncle previously that I acted, has to be exaggerated, do stupid things, then I think I'll do that.